One Zambia, One Nation. Good evening, and thank you so much for joining us on the main news at 18 hours here on ZNBC TV2. Let's quickly look at the top stories. The Electoral Commission of Zambia has warned that it may be compelled to suspend political campaigns if political violence escalates. 17-year-old Brian Zulu, the teenage boy who was admitted to the University Teaching Hospital after fire swept through the house the family was sleeping in, has died. And the Zambia national soccer team has left for Namibia to take part in the COSAFA tournament. With the news in detail, my name is Penifer Nurenda. The Electoral Commission of Zambia, ECZ, has warned that it may be compelled to suspend political campaigns and disqualify parties from participating in elections if political violence escalates. ECZ Public Relations Manager Chris Akfuna says the commission has observed with dismay the rising levels of violence and intolerance, as well as the total disregard of the Electoral Code of Conduct in political campaigns. Mr. Akfuna said during a media briefing in Lusaka today that all political parties must ensure their candidates, cadres and supporters abide by the Electoral Code of Conduct. More on the story in this report.
Zambia heads to the polls on August 11th to elect new leaders. But as the campaigns have gained momentum, a worrying trend has emerged as the country witnesses escalating levels of political violence. Today, the Electoral Commission of Zambia has warned that it will not hesitate to suspend political campaigns and disqualify those engaging in political violence from taking part in the general election. Citing Section 28 of the Electoral Act No. 35 of 2016, ECZ Public Relations Manager Chris Akufuna says the Act is very clear on the need to have a peaceful period during campaigns and the need to observe the Electoral Code of Conduct in the run-up to the general election.
It's to all political parties, including the Patriotic Front and the UPND. And that is how it comes. It's to all. And just to remind them that, look, Article 110 gives the Commission power to disqualify. So I don't know how stern you want that warning to be, but we are saying we have this power and we are reminding them that please conduct yourself in an orderly manner. Otherwise, the Commission is going to invoke this section.
Under this law, the ECZ is empowered to suspend campaigns in its quest for a credible election. Major political parties have been caught in accusations and counter-accusations of inciting political violence. The ruling PF and the opposition UPND, however, say they are doing their share of stopping the scourge.
So we are relying on the police to do their part and ensure that culprits are brought to book. Our people are being attacked every day in broad daylight, and we have been continuing to restrain our cadres. Our prayer and hope is that the police will do their part professionally, bring the culprits to book, because Zambians are prepared to vote.
And I want to repeat, it's incumbent upon those whose mandate is to run the country to bring this to a halt. You remember President Mwanawasa, may his soul rest in peace, stopped it. Just by a statement, and it was over. And it's possible to stop it. We have lost lives of innocent citizens in Zambia because of this hooliganism violence in political life, which is not right.
Zambia's credentials as a peaceful and stable democracy are on the line as the country heads towards the August 11th poll due to the escalating levels of political violence. Michael Kaumba, ZNBC News, Lusaka.
Still on that subject, the Ministry of Home Affairs has issued a stern warning to political cadres championing violence during campaigns for the August 11 polls. Ministry of Home Affairs spokesperson Moses Wali says there will be no sacred cows in the application of the law against perpetrators of political violence. Mr. Swali was speaking in an interview with ZNBC News in Lusaka today. He said violence has the potential to negatively affect the country's peaceful climate and democracy. Mr. Swali called on politicians to cherish peace and democracy. Candidates for Matera parliamentary seat have declared the constituency as violence-free. All the four candidates from UNEP, FDD, UPND and PF say they have instructed their supporters not to engage in any act of violence. Those contesting the Matera seat are Tom Michello for UPND, Sydney Chewe for FDD, Lloyd Kazia for PF and Philemon Luabila for UNEP. More in this report.
Various political parties have stepped up campaigns ahead of the August 11 elections. In Matera constituents, four political parties are contesting the parliamentary seat. These are United National Independence Party, UNIP, Forum for Democracy and Development, FDD, United Party for National Development, UPND, and the Patriotic Front, PF. And residents of Matera have high expectations from whoever will become Matera Member of Parliament.
With so that she a constituency San Fandi San Sechta Kata Conse
Pataka Tem Pimo Matero, the Bataruka, Boneca Tefami Kwakwa, Fama Tuareti, Kafela Batani Mefatin.
Meanwhile, the four candidates have a number of priorities if elected into office. The UNIP candidate, Philemon Wabila, says he has put education top on his agenda if elected MP.
Right, so they need facilities such as a library. It is my intention to put up a library to at least assist our students. Yes, and in the process, parents, or this will cut down on the parents' expenditure, all right? They will have the facility in their own area.
And FDD candidate Sidim Chewe wants to ensure that women trade in decent markets.
The old Matera constituency does not have a functional market with structures built on them. So we'd like to lay up markets for our women and also to introduce the no-interest loans for our women. Because if at all you look at our mothers in Katambalala Market 1 and 2, and also you go to Chunga Market, Chunga Market has got a market that was started, but it isn't finished.
Meanwhile, PF candidate Lloyd Kaziam wants improved water reticulation and sanitation.
We want to improve the capacity of those tanks. We have new areas that have come up, Matera North, SOS, GRZ, Barraston area. We have new places. As such, we want to reach them with water reticulation and sanitation. We want to ensure that they have piped water. That is priority number one. Prep.
And UPND candidate Tom Michello has promised to empower youths and women if elected.
Create employment for youths, women empowerment. As you are aware, a lot of youths are not working, they are unemployed at the moment because three quarters of our industries have been closed. And it is our prayer that working together with the community, we can come up with initiatives on how we can create employment.
The candidates and the residents have given their views, and what is remaining now is to see who will become Matera Member of Parliament after August 11. Prince Chuni, TV2 News. In Lusaka.
Meanwhile, in Western Province, candidates contesting in Kalawo Central constituency are happy with the prevailing peace in the area. And the candidates from all participating political parties have pledged to preach messages of peace and love before, during and after the elections. They have told Zanis in separate interviews that the peaceful atmosphere has enabled them to freely sell their manifestos and are optimistic that the electorate will make an informed decision. Patriotic Front PF candidate Sikwebele Mwapelwa says the peaceful environment has enabled him to fully explain his party's programs in the district. And United Party for National Development UPND candidate Chinga Miutu and Forum for Democracy and Development FDD's Kalaluka Mubukwanu both say the district is conducive for opposition political parties to carry out campaigns. Mr. Miutu said he will enhance development if elected. And Mr. Mwukwanu also pledged to develop the constituency once again, once given a five-year parliamentary mandate. The candidates are all confident of scooping the parliamentary seat. Authorities from the Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC, have handed over 76 Ethiopian nationals who were stuffed in a containerized lorry, leaving 19 others dead on the Pedico Road. And two of the Ethiopian nationals who were detained in the DRC have suspected cholera symptoms. The Ethiopians, who were in transit to South Africa to scout for job opportunities, were only released this afternoon after a meeting between Zambian and DRC's senior government officials, among them security personnel. DRC's Haut Katanga Interior Minister Kasongo Kabile led the team from the neighboring country, while Consular General in Lubumbashi Davis Sankwana led the Zambian delegation. The Ethiopians arrived on the Zambian side at Mukambo border post in a Fuso fighter open lorry amid tight security before subjecting them to screening by immigration officers. A ZNBC news crew that went to Mukambo border post found several Ethiopian nationals being offloaded from the lorry and appeared to be weak and dehydrated. And an Ethiopian national told ZNBC News that the driver of the lorry deliberately ignored their cry for help when it became apparent that there was not enough air to breathe, leaving others suffocating and eventually dead. Mr. Kaska Lengwaya said the group was using Zambia as a transit point to South Africa, where another colleague was waiting for them on the condition that they would be offered lucrative jobs. And Zambia's Consular General Davis Sankwana thanked authorities from the neighboring country for reaching an amicable solution for the release of the foreign nationals. You're watching the main news at 18 hours here on TV2. And still to come in the news, Lusaka has been declared cholera-free. This and more stories coming up after this break. Thank you for staying with us. We continue with the news. 17-year-old Brian Zulu, the teenage boy who was admitted to the university teaching hospital after fire swept through the house the family was sleeping in, has died. Brian died yesterday after being in hospital for more than 2 weeks. His aunt, Violet Mwila, has confirmed the development to TV2 News. And Lusaka District Commissioner Davidson Mulenga has visited the funeral house and also donated assorted food items. Captain Mulenga has described the death of Brian as unfortunate and painful. Four members of the same family died after fire swept through the house they were sleeping in Lusaka's Zingalume compound last month. The only survivor is 3-year-old Ades Zulu, who has since been discharged from hospital. The Ministry of Health has declared Lusaka cholera-free. This means the ministry has managed to contain the disease. Lusaka Province Medical Officer Kennedy Malama says the ministry has not recorded any cholera case in the past 14 days. Dr. Malama was speaking in an interview with TV2 News. He has since advised the public to continue practicing good hygiene.
The first cases in Lusaka district as a province, including Rufunsa and Chongwe, we've recorded a total of 1,079 cases. And we lost a total of 23 people from this cholera outbreak. But what is important to note is that in the last 14 days, we've not recorded any new case of cholera. And from the public health point of view, once 14 days elapses in an outbreak of cholera, you don't record any new case, then you declare the outbreak over. So for this particular outbreak we've had, we can confidently say that the outbreak is over. But our appeal to the members of the public is that this cholera germ is still with us. So what it means is that we still need to ensure that we heighten our access to clean and safe drinking water.
A total number of 1,079 cholera cases were recorded during the outbreak from 5th February 2016, with 23 deaths occurring. In other news, the Professional Teachers Union of Zambia, PROTUS, has urged teachers to be patient as government upgrades all those that submitted their qualifications. Union Deputy Secretary General Victor Muyumba says government has promised to ensure that all teachers are upgraded by the end of the month. Mr. Muyumba has also urged all teachers with qualifications to submit their documents to the District Education Board Secretary's DEBS. Mr. Muyumba was speaking in an interview with TV2 News in Lusaka.
To the teachers out there,
that our government has undertaken to upgrade all those teachers that were not upgraded in January. And information has been collected from all the provinces and districts, which information is being worked on. So this month in June, we expect to see some developments. And we'd like to commend government for expanding the existing schools and also creating new ones, which has necessitated the employment of 6,000 teachers. And we are appealing to those that have qualifications to take this opportunity and apply.
The National Council for Construction, NCC, has rolled out to other provinces the training of women and youths in the use of cobblestone technology. NCC Executive Director Charles Moshota says the training is progressing well and that the council wants women and youths from other provinces to benefit. Mr. Moshota praised the Rural Development Agency, RDA, and other partners for making the finances available for the program. Mr. Moshota was speaking in an interview with TV2 News. The RDA and NCC have partnered to train women and youths in the use of cobblestone technology. The graduates are expected to help in the Pave Zambia Road project. We take another break. Coming up is international and sports news.